Hey, welcome guys to my grammar class today. Today I want to just inform you that I have faced two questions often by just what by the inspectors and just officials when they are entering into the English class. I have just faced two questions. What are they? But simple questions. If I said the answer, you'll be thinking, is it these questions are asked by the officials? The answer is yes. What are the two questions? Suddenly they'll come and ask you, what are the two parts of sentence? I'll repeat once again. They'll come and ask you, just suddenly they ask the students, come on, you get up. Can I ask, sir? Just one official told me, sir, can I ask some question to that student? I said, okay, sir, you can just welcome. He asked one student to get up and he asked, what are the two parts of sentence, he said. The student immediately what it came in his mind is the parts of speech, because it's also a part in the sentence. He said two, noun, verb, like that, and said, he said wrong. Even I also was shocked, what is the two parts of, what are the two parts in sentence? Then he said, what simple question, is not answering it. And he said, subject, predicate. He immediately just recalled. Yes. So broadly speaking, in every sentence, there are two parts and it's called as subject, predicate. What is subject? Subject which about the person. Okay? About the person or place or thing is said about, said is subject. Predicate, what about the person, place or thing is had been said about. That is called as predicate. So what is the simple question, what are the parts of sentence? Immediately you want to just answer subject, predicate, subject about the person, and predicate what has been told about him, place or a thing. Okay, the question number two, same experience I had. What are the numbers in English? One official asked in my class, what are the numbers in English? Even I also was just little shocked. What are the numbers in English? I had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it'll be going on, it's indefinite. We can't there is no end for the numbers. So he's asking, what are the numbers? No, just what? And he just asked the student, no one said. English, there was completely blank. Then he asked me, sir, what simple question they're not answering? You want to teach them grammar correctly, he said. Very simple answer, because I can't answer it now. There are two numbers in English. One is singular, then you know automatically another is plural. Singular is one and plural more than one. See, simple question, the two questions you want to be very careful. First question, I'll repeat. What are the two parts of the sentence? Subject and predicate. Question number two, what are the numbers in English? There are two numbers in English, singular and plural. So two questions you can face in this area. What are the two questions? What are the two numbers in English? So you can say subject, plural. How many just what numbers are in English? You can say two. So once again, I'm repeating. What are the two parts in a sentence? Subject, predicate, and so question number two, what are the numbers in English? That is singular, plural. Okay, so guys, you want to be very careful when these kinds of simple questions only ask. See, these two questions are very simple, but most of us, we don't know. But we are not keeping these kinds of simple things in the mind. And even this question, in your competitive examination or any examination, can be asked. Nowadays, they are asking different kinds of questions in the competitive examination. So we want to be very careful to answer all these questions. Okay. So just thank you for listening to my video.